Welcome to Castletown Bere, a seaside town on the spectacular Beara Peninsula in West Cork. The ferry is arriving to take us on a virtual tour of Bere Island, officially known in Irish as On a Long Moor, meaning the Big Island.
So where are we off to today?
Bere Island.
Very good. And how long have you been running this ferry service?
Too long. About 50 years, I'd say.
Oh, brilliant. So you've been serving the island for over 50 years?
Yeah, and my father was doing it before that. Not as often, or not in a... When we started off, if you wanted to bring your car on, there'd be two planks put across the boat and you'd drive it on the two planks. They were just the width of the wheels, so you had to be good. But now it's so much easier, just drop the ramp and reverse on.
And how important is your ferry service to the islanders on Bere Island?
Well, it's the lifeline to the island, really. I suppose it makes life much easier on the island than what it used to be long ago, where everything had to be handled. But people come out now on the rural transport bus and just do their shopping, put it on the bus and go back in, or as they shop online in the Super Value and they'll put it down into the boardroom and they just collect it on the other side. Or they come out and do their shopping, they're able to push their trolley onto the boat and unload it into their car on the island and then just put the trolley back on the boat and just brought back out.
Very handy. So long ago, would people have rowed over as well?
Like, would there have been small boats rowing over and there wouldn't have been a ferry, like somebody would be asking their neighbour, are you going to town today? Can you get me this? Or can I go with you? But this is the island here in front of you then, from the west end, it's right all the way down.
So how far is it from Castletown Bere?
It's about a mile. 10-15 minutes.
We've arrived on Bere, and throughout the trip, we'll be meeting islanders who will show us around.
Jenna, lovely to meet you here on Bere Island.
And you too.
You run local bus tours here on the island. You might tell us about some of the favourite spots that you go to.
We do, yes. In the summertime, normally we'd start and we'd go to the entrance to Adnakinna Lighthouse, and from there you can look down at the Dunboy Castle and the old fortifications down there from when the British were here. And then we head over towards the village along the high road, and on that road there's a standing stone that we stop at, and from there you can see right down as far as Bantry Bay and out to Sheepshead Lighthouse. So then we continue on, and normally we end up at Lone Hot Fort, which is fabulous. It's the most amazing place you'll see, and everybody's very interested in that, with the old guns and everything there. So then we turn around and go back again.
Lovely, lovely. Well, I'm really looking forward to getting to see all those highlights here on Bere Island.
Yes, they're beautiful, and you've a perfect day for it today.
We really do. Stunning weather.
Next, we're off to meet local historian Ted O'Sullivan, who will share some of the island's early history.
So, Ted, we're up in Lonehart Harbour. You might tell us a little bit about what's behind you.
Right, so here, Coon Lonehart, Ainoy Communion, Loganimson, Lonehart, Longford, At Lunkard, Limnach, Bin Buntikilish, and Lucknanig, Agus Bowling and so. The Honig UCC and so, Dr. John Sheehan, Exchange, Tuckle, Shandal Yukta, Agus Forshe. Macrev noust and shaw, she shin oit, stuck a lung close to couldn't look like, I was fishing his sauce of hunya. Ega Puinton son, Cossack letter and Buinta son, Agus Ega Buinta ta, Marifak, working nature breakwater, Agus in Balochine, Bialidisha, Anitere, Mar, rather hog, no look like, con a could lunga, a hostant and saw. Os na tomt amúra haag gwishtach. An log anam Longford, long is a anam gwaelach ar baad, agus gletar long boats ar na baad a bhiach agin a Lochlinnig sin focal cianea. An rodele fin oitcha na in seedig agus a do, treis cacion paila, da hannig an Sulawani, gar aast on coma Sulawan bear, agus da chan sir aastin siogadí lehenish feira, de hokri seig a gusgurin seig gnaag seig cosint, in Long Garav, I was going to stop Oxen assassinate attacked. After Hanader Erlong Obion Tree, General Carew, Oxanche Stackenshaw, the Tree Long, Trinity of Waterford, Agus Ankyong Bavovige, Agus Gar Long Illa, Agus the Stackenshaw Hanig on Aram Vige, Agus the Gloucester Har and Ilan, Variadur Glordina, Valiadurdina Elecon could go near Umper, Agus the Vicompa Cotter and Def Hirden Lawn, Agus Kodamakrimur here, Con Leagarcher Dunbui, Leagar Kai Luil, Agus Pederin Scale and Son, nor Hoga Dunbui, Agus Lagadere, Gur Grav Osulman Bear A Lu, Goody Kunde Goody Brefni, Agus Vian Cooltrid Moor, Kai Luil Son, at the Hanashi Asson. Because she's second sort of honey caru and kid law.
Now we'll meet Barry Handley up at Lonehart Battery to talk about its important heritage.
This particular fort here was built around the start of the 1900s. Okay. And it was a totally self-contained. It was a huge investment in terms of the building of it. It was only part of seven other batteries that were here on Bere Island at the time. This one had 2 6-inch guns and a 9-inch gun, which is no longer here in place. Okay. But as I said, that was a huge investment. The main thing is that if there was any enemy forces approaching, yeah, that they could be blown out of the water, really.
Right.
They also had huge searchlights. Mm. They had massive generators located here on this site. They could light up the bay here in this area. And so it was part of the defence, and really it was part of, this was only one spot, if you like, in a British Empire context, really, that this was very important in Southwest Europe. So that's the particular significance. Interestingly then, that that was the beginning of 1900s. Bearhaven Harbour was very involved in the First World War then. And in 1921 then, when Ireland became independent, it was one of the ports kept and known as the treaty ports.
Right.
So you had a very unusual situation that the British controlled part of Bere Island between 1921 and 1938, and the rest of Bere Island was under Irish government.
Wow.
I suppose we were fortunate then that in 1938 that the British had given them back to Ireland, to the Irish government, in 1938, the year before the Second World War. So this space here was not really involved in the Second World War, which was probably fortunate for a lot of us.
Absolutely. You know. Oh, fascinating history.
So that's the kind of background to it, yeah.
So now I'm joined by Teresa Hall, and you run a lovely B&B here on Bere Island. Teresa, you might tell us a little bit about island life here on Bere Island.
Well, I suppose island life is, when you're born on the island, it's you don't take any notice, you grow up with what you have, and but it's after improving a lot now and for the last 20 or 30 years compared with previous. Everywhere, you had to walk everywhere. Mm. I got a bicycle one time, it was, to have a bicycle was like getting an aeroplane. then there was hardship farming as well. Mm. For to get cattle to Castletown, they had to go out on the ferries, and now lorries come in or trailers come in and take them.
Yeah.
But there was one time we had a cow that was doing a bit of rambling, and my father said for to take her to the fair in Castletown, and I don't think I was ever at a fair actually, previous to that, but I had to walk the cow from here to the West End.
Mm.
And we had her on a rope because cattle were quieter that time because they were tied in stalls, like.
Yeah.
And my sister Christina came with me as far as the Heritage Centre, and I went out on the ferry then over, and there was one man looking out for me all day because he was afraid that the buyers, when they'd see a woman selling, that they would try and diddle me, like.
Yeah, of course.
But anyway, I got $37.50 for the cow, so that'll tell you how long ago.
Wow.
That was.
God, amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing, Teresa.
Yeah.
Teresa, we're surrounded by history here as well. There's two towers.
Yes.
There's one up here and one here. You might tell us a little bit about the towers.
The towers were built around the 1800s.
Okay.
And Martello Towers, they're a replica of the towers that were built in Corsica.
Right.
Because when the British went there to help with a battle, they had two ships out there. They saw that they couldn't break it down, and they saw how it was built.
Yeah.
And they replicated that then for in time afterwards when they were building towers all around Ireland and everything. So it was hard slog getting stuff up those hills.
I can imagine. Yeah. Amazing. Fascinating. Yeah, you really are surrounded, aren't you, by beauty and history.
Yeah, history.
So now I'm joined by John Walsh, who's the project coordinator of the Bere Island Project Group. Yeah. And John, we're outside the Heritage Centre. Might tell us a little bit about what's inside.
So the Heritage Centre, we set it up maybe around 2010, I think it was officially opened by President Mary McAleese. So inside the Heritage Centre you have, first of all, you have the whole story of Bere Island. So there's different information panels that you can walk in and you can get a tour right across all the history of the island, right from the Vikings, you know, the Bronze Age wedge tombs, right to up to modern day times about the ferries and all that. Inside the Heritage Centre there's a lot of information you can get. So if you're looking for your family, you know, there's genealogical records, there's artifact records, there is a photographic database, we have a graveyard database, we have the full architectural survey done on the island of every building on the island. So there's a lot of information inside there if people need it. And we also have a lot of information that we got in Kew in London on the military archives. Uh-huh. So there's a lot of drawings and maps and stuff inside there as well. Well, so a lot inside there.
Bere Island certainly is full of history and heritage here, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a huge history and it's kind of, I suppose it's unique compared to other islands because it was a British Army base up to 1938. Actually today was the official day of the handover 82 years ago.
Wow. Yeah. So what date was that?
26th of September 38 was when it was officially handed back.
Amazing.
Yeah, it was one of the treaty ports, like, so has a fascinating history and it's still being found out. Like, there's a lot of stories, even Ted and Barry today and Teresa, you could hear a lot of different stories.
Absolutely, yeah.
You could be filling him here for weeks probably.
We could. We're only scratching the surface, aren't we? Yeah.
We end our journey in the village. This is where Murphy's Ferry departs and will take us back to the mainland. We hope you've enjoyed the history and fascinating stories here on Bere Island, as well as the beautiful scenery. Be sure to make a trip to Bere Island and see it for yourself in person. Slán agus gurbh maith agat.